I remember the way you used to wait. 'Twas there that you whispered tenderly that you loved me. You'd always be my lily of the lamplight, my only darling. Time would come for all, time for us to part. Darling, I'd caress you and press you to my heart, and there beneath that far off lantern light, I'd hold you tight. We'd kiss good night, my lily of the lamplight, my own lily Marley. Sing as we go.
Most young girls now just shout and wail. The melody's gone, I think. You can tell now if a song is good if you can hum it when you've heard it play. But how many songs can you hum to now? Just one or two, I say. This is practically a true one about a member of my family. A trip to Lowestoft in the 40s. Mrs. Parker caught a bus to go shopping in the town. They had more style and comfort then, and painted cream and brown. She caught the bus at Gunton, which stopped at M&S. Opposite was the Odeon, the cinema that was the best. As she climbed down the step to leave the bus, the elastic went in her drawers. They fell to her feet, in her pocket they went, and she hurried to Catherine's stores. She felt quite embarrassed, not knowing who had seen her point. She asked the laundry assistant what knickers they sold in white. I want ones of strong elastic that come up to my chest, and if they're really roomy, I can tuck them in my vest. She paid for some she fancied. It didn't take her long. The assistant said, shall I wrap them? Oh no, I'm going to put them on. She popped in Wallen's later for a cake and a cup of tea. The time just flew. She looked at the clock. It was nearly 3:10. Oh, I must go and catch my bus, she thought, and then began to sneeze. She pulled the old drawers from their pocket. She thought, I'll have to blow my nose on these. She caught her bus to smash a room and walked the short way home. I'd better hurry and get Fred's tea, or else they'll only move. Did you have a nice day, he asked her. I can't smell cooking or fresh bread. Well, I went on the bus for Lowestoft, with a nice ham salad instead. Thank you.